as an L gaming. Now with my Assassin's Creed 3 part 1, the first part. And also I'm hoping to do a video. So that'll be exciting to start. Let's start. You know. Yes, well.
Used to be when people talked about the end of the world, we locked them up or laughed them off. Sometimes both, but we never took them seriously. Maybe we should have. But I'm getting ahead of myself. Better to start at the beginning with the abduction of Desmond Miles, my son. This boy had no ambition, no direction, no plans for the future. What he did have was a heritage, one he chose to deny. It nearly cost him his life. He was captured and imprisoned. Those who took him believed he could help them find something. The apple. One of several artifacts we call pieces of Eden. Bits of ancient technology scattered across the globe. Some hidden, some found. All of them dangerous. Most are held by a single group. The same group that now had Desmond. You know them as Abstergo Industries. We know them as the Templars. As the enemy. We've been fighting them for thousands of years. Even longer if you believe the stories of their origins. I do. After all, I've seen the truth. That's the beauty and the horror of the Animus. A device that allows us to enter and experience the lives of our ancestors. It holds the power to change everything, to show us history the way it really happened. Up until its creation, to the victor went the spoils, went the truth. We're trying to fix that, to free minds and bodies both. But there's only so much that we can do, and the Templars have the upper hand these days. But something larger than the Assassins and Templars is approaching, bigger than all of us. And if we can't find a way to stop it, these next few weeks will probably be our last. Everyone's last. In the end, it all comes down to him. To Desmond. Through the Animus, he discovered his heritage, explored the lives of his ancestors, and uncovered their secrets. When that was done, he trained. He used another ancestor to provide decades of experience in the span of a few days. It worked. We think. We hope. Soon, though, soon we'll know. That ominous date fast approaches, December 21st, 2012. None of us knows what it'll bring, only that this is where they want us to be. When it does. They've been guiding us in their own fractured, frustrating way. These voices from the first civilization, the ones who came before, a precursor race of immense power and uncertain motives. They're the ones who made the pieces of Eden. This is where they've led him, and through him, us. He stands at the entrance to this long-lost place, armed with the knowledge of Altair and the abilities of Ezio. He holds in his hands the Apple of Eden, and we stand at his side, ready to support him however we can. His name is Desmond Miles, and he has brought us to the end. Here. Let's go.
Okay. In another moment, down went Alice after it, never once considering how in the world she was to get out again.
Desmond?
Do you hear us?
Yeah. What happened?
The temple triggered a bleeding effect. You collapsed and entered into a fugue state.
So naturally, you dropped me into the Animus instead of, I don't know, making sure I was okay?
You weren't in any danger. Besides, the temple appeared to be communicating with you, and I didn't want to risk severing the connection. At least not until we knew what it wanted.
Right. Of course.
Son, I...
No, it's fine. I get it. And I know what I'm looking for, by the way. It's a key. Just no idea where it is, though. I guess that's why she triggered the bleeding effect.
She?
Juno, Dad. She's talking to me.
Okay, Desmond. While you were, visiting Constantinople, we picked up a software update for the Animus. I'd like to run a couple of quick tests, make sure there aren't any major issues.
All right. What do you need me to do?
We'll start simple. Walk to the marker over there. Okay, Desmond. Let's practice climbing on these objects.
What's easy?
That's a constraint. These are optional objectives that raise your synchronization rate. All right, Desmond. Follow the on-screen instructions and kill the two Templars. All you have to do here is jump the gap. Synchronization levels look good now. You should be able to build the world. Time to find out what the temple wants from you.
What the fuck?
Everything all right, sir?
Yes, fine. I'm just preoccupied, that's all.
Don't forget your invitation. Master Birch will be meeting you inside.
Thank you.
Where shall I retrieve you once you're done?
Front of the Opera House. And be quick about it. Don't expect to be here long.
I'll bring her round at once.
Invitation, please. Shall I take your coat, sir?
Shall I take your coat, sir?
Well, so he says. Divine miracles of applied alchemy.
Ladies and gentlemen, you are requested to kindly find your seat.
Read it.
Very posh in the royal.
Good evening, sir. This way, please.
Sorry. This is right.
My apologies.
Of course it is safe.
Evening, Haytham.
Reginald?
I can't tell you how happy I was to hear they'd mounted this revival. Gay's best work by far. Have you seen it before?
Once. My father brought me here as a child. Though I remember little of it. But I suppose tonight will afford me the luxury of a proper viewing either.
No, I'm afraid it won't. On to business, then. Do you see him?
And a statesman because he's so great thinks his trade as honest as mine. A lawyer is an honest employment, so is mine. Like me too, he acts in a double capacity, both against Rhodes and for Rhodes. For it is but fitting that we should protect and encourage...
He's seated in one of the boxes above.
The stairs are watched.
Sir,
you'll need to find another way up.
That word of trial comes on in the afternoon, and she hopes you will order
I already have.
So as to bring her off.
As the wench is very active and industrious, you may satisfy her that I'll soften the evidence.
Tom Cagg, sir, is found guilty.
A lazy dog! When I took him the time before, I told him what would come to if he did not mend his
hands. 1,000 pardons.
This is death.
My apologies.
I may venture to book him. For Tom Cagg, £40. Let Betty Sly know I'll save her from the transportation. I can get more by her staying in.
Betty have brought more goods into our loft here than any five of the gang. And in truth, it is a pity to lose so good a customer.
If none of the gang take her off, she may, in the common course of business, live at 12 months longer. I love to let women escape. A good sportsman always lets the end partridges fly, because the breed of the game depends on it. Besides, here the law allows us no reward. There is nothing to be got by the death of women, except our wives.
Without dispute, she is a fine woman. 'Twas to her I was obliged for my education. And to say a bold word, she hath trained up more young fellows to the business than the gaming table.
Truly, Filch, thine observation is right. We and the surgeons are more beholden to women than all the professions besides.
So, that call, that sick word of trial, comes on in the afternoon. And she hopes to order the back to the
Pick lock. That's your holly looks. This is really holly looks.
Of love like law, a one by time, and still they must be treated to
Boy, and let your friends know where I intend. Well, I love to make them.
When a gentleman is long kept in suspense, penitence may break his spirit ever after. Besides, certainty gives a man a good air upon his trials, and makes him risk another without fear or scruple. But all the way, but 'tis a pleasure to be the messenger of comfort to pains and affliction.
But 'tis now high time to look about me for a decent execution. Against next session.
I've got a bit of stage fright.
A lazy rogue, by whom one can get nothing till he's hanged. A register of the gang. Crook-fingered jackals. A year and a half in the service. Let me see how much the stock owes to his industry. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5 gold,
was really burning and 7 silver tonight. He's a
mighty clean dannered fellow. 16 snuff boxes, 5 of them true gold, 6 dozen of handkerchiefs, 4 silver hilted swords, 6 dozen of shirts, 3 tie periwigs.
Hey, Ethel. You should have come to me. We would have found another way. Yes. But then you would have known. For what it's worth, I'm sorry. FMI.
That kid has freaky eyes.
And how was the opera?
Rather dull, truth be told.
Shall we be off then?
Aye. To Fleet and Bride.
By your command.
Fascinating. Gentlemen, I hold in my hand a key. If this book is to be believed, it will open the doors of a storehouse built by those who came before.
Ah, yes. Those who ruled, reigned, and vanished from the world. Do we know what it is that will be held within?
It could contain certain knowledge. Perhaps a weapon, or something as yet unknown, unfathomable in its construction and purpose. It could be any of these things, or none of them. They are still an enigma, these precursors. But of one thing I am certain. Whatever waits behind those doors shall prove a great boon to us all.
Or our enemies, should they find it first.
They won't. You've seen to that.
I assume you know where this storehouse is?
Ah, Mr. Harrison.
Gentlemen.
How fair your calculations?
I believe the site lies somewhere within this region.
That's a lot of ground to cover.
My apologies. Were that I could be more accurate.
That's all right. It suffices for a start. And that is why we've called you here, Master Kenway. We'd like you to travel to America, locate the storehouse, and take possession of its contents.
I'm yours to command, although a job of this magnitude will require more than just myself.
Of course. Upon this paper are the names of 5 men sympathetic to our cause. Each is also uniquely suited to aid you in your endeavor. With them at your side, we'll want for nothing.
Well, then I'd best be on my way.
I knew our faith in you was not misplaced. We booked you passage to Boston. Your ship leaves at dawn. Go forth, Haytham, and bring honor to us all.
I love it. Don't want to sing that bow. I actually like the way we look. We look so cool.
And then all will be well.
You sure about that?
Of course. Have I ever led you astray?
Nah. Though you don't sit right with the others.
Have faith, my friend. You'll see.
Well, well. Seems our esteemed guest has deigned to grace us with his presence. You might want to head back to your quarters. Top deck's no place for tender Parnell.
So I thought.
And yet here you are. Fancy yourself a joker, eh? Let's see how funny you find this.
That's enough, Graves. Stay out of this.
Find this bitch. Find this.
Come on, brother, dodge! Dodge!
Find that.
Listen to this, Hector. Thinks he can swagger on up here and declare himself king of the castle.
Please, fellas, call this off. If the captain sees
us... To hell with the captain. And to hell with you, Mills. Who starts you on anyway?
Look at how he bumbles about.
Bitch.
Anointing with the oil of gladness already. I want my money.
We're ready to go again if you are.
This is unwise.
Why is that? You think I'm afraid of you?
No. But you should be. Do you yield?
Never!
You like these twice?
Not these odds.
Not X.
Explain yourself at once, Mr. Kenway.
These folk...
We were simply passing the time with a bit of sport, Captain.
How about you pass the time by doing your goddamn jobs instead? I wasn't aware I was paying you to loll about.
Fucking hell.
A word, please, Mr. Kenway.
Oh, I nearly forgot. There's your knife back.
I don't care for you, Mr. Kenway. I've had nothing but trouble since you came aboard.
Your problems have nothing to do with me.
I beg your pardon?
You're a poor leader, ill-tempered and cruel, and it's clear your crew has no respect for you.
Look, I don't want to argue. In fact, I need a favor.
Oh, this is rich.
I suspect some of the men intend to mutiny.
Really? What a surprise.
As I cannot trust any of them, I am compelled to turn to you.
And why should I help you?
Because if they do intend to betray, I'm the only hope you have of reaching America alive. Well, what will it be?
If what you say is true, what other choice do I have?
Thank you.
But let me be clear. Should you ever dare to insult or threaten me again, I'll not hesitate but to cut off your head myself. Are we understood?
Dare.
Excellent. Good day.
Mr. Kenway.
Captain?
Whatever they're up to, I believe it's coming to a head.
I'd best get to work.
He's got our rations again. Claims we're not provisioned for such luxuries.
It's not right that you should feast on
land. He's a shifty fella. Won't hardly take his hat off. Keeps his face in too, so we can't see him watch.
Quiet! Here he comes. Make like you're working.
You there. I have some questions for you.
That's nice, but I ain't got time to gossip. Probably wouldn't have anything useful to share anyway. You want information? Try the cook or the doctor. Everyone's always chatting them up.
Won't be serving for another couple hours. Some biscuits in the barrel if you're desperate.
Actually, I've come with a question.
What's that?
Have any of the men been acting strange recently? Said anything that struck you as out of the ordinary?
The boys cry about the rations, as if there's anything I can do about it. But beyond that, I ain't heard much. My advice? Go find James. His ears are always open.
And where might I find him?
Right behind you, actually. He's the one sitting on the barrel.
Let it all be hanging.
Are you James?
Aye.
Haytham Kenway. Pleased to meet you.
I know who you are.
I was hoping you could answer some questions.
I figured as much, but not here. Follow me. So, what do you want to know?
Have you seen or heard anything out of the ordinary since we left port? Anything that gives cause for concern?
Some of the men have been gathering at night on the upper deck. I've only caught bits of their conversations, so I couldn't say for certain what they're up to. But I suspect it bodes ill.
Is it a mutiny they're planning?
All I know is they've little love for the captain. Mills has been trying to talk him down, but there's only so much one man can do.
Thank you for the information.
I only wish to see us reach the colonies alive.
Evening, sir.
How are things?
Calm and quiet, just the way I like it. What brings you topside?
Thought I'd wander a bit, stretch my legs, that's all.
Take care where you tread. The deck hides all manner of danger in the dark.
What was that? Someone's throwing cargo overboard. But why?
Claims we're not provisioned for such luxuries.
It's not right that you should feast on lamb and wine. We're stuck with tinned fish and biscuits.
Someone needs to have words with them.
Mills, try. Captain Turner.
So if you enjoy, leave a comment, subscribe for more of Assassin's Creed, Far Cry, all of our things. Just can't see in the end of the episode, and I shall see you in the next episode.
Any news? Each night it's the same. I scout one area, and they dropped the painted barrels from another. I'm going to need to recruit an extra pair of eyes. Maybe James or Mills.
Why are they doing this?
Near as I can tell, the barrels serve as markers. They're leaving a trail. My fear is it's only a matter of time before whoever's following it...
Ship sighted aft! She's making ready to fire!
Beat to quarters, men! Ready the... Brace! Everybody down! We'll be right back. warning shot. Seems they don't mean to sink us, but board us instead. Man the cannons! Make ready to fight! I want you below decks.
Why? Let me help you secure the ship.
Do you know how to rig a sail? To load a cannon? To wage war at sea? I didn't think so. Now return to your cabin, or do I need to have you escorted? Secure the hatch!
Haytham. Have you been topside? A ship's appeared and means to board us. It's strange. There's no sign of mutiny aboard. Doesn't make sense.
Ah, but it does.
What do you mean?
Did you think you could escape from London so easily after what you did at the opera? That we wouldn't notice? That we wouldn't follow?
Oh. So that's what this is about.
Surrender, and I will see that you are treated with honor.
If you wish to treat me with honor, give me a sword.
Sure, this is how you want to play it.
Decks.
I did as you asked. Only Mills was there waiting for me. He's the one that drew that ship here. There was no mutiny. Only him.
What do they want?
Me.
Then they can have you.
Is that so?
You'll catch us anyway. There's nothing to be done.
I can think of something.
You wish us to sail into the storm?
It's our only chance.
I won't do it.
Then I will.
All right, all right.
Fix your sail for you.
Thank you.
Well, I'm probably actually going to keep landing on the right there.
Make ready for our arrival, men!
Arrival? I see no land, only this interminable fog.
The gulls tell us all we need to know. Climb into the crow's nest and you'll see.
Wow, wonderful.
Master Kenway! Master Kenway!
Oh, yes, thank you.
Charles Lee, sir. A pleasure to make your acquaintance. I've been asked to introduce you to the city, help you settle in. Oh, no need, sir. I've arranged for your bags to be delivered to the inn.
Are you by any chance John and Isabella's son?
One and the same.
Is it not?
Aye. But he's yet to reach America, and I figured I might... Well, at least until he arrives, I thought...
Yes? Out with it?
Forgive me, sir. I had hoped that I might study under you. If I am to centaur, then yourself.
Kind of you to say, but I think you overestimate me.
Impossible, sir. Bloody this hell. Way.
Someone stop him!
Boston's quite a lively city.
What are these?
There's all manner of things to see and do. Once you've settled in, I suggest you take some time to walk the streets. Who knows what opportunities.
Hold a moment. We need to fetch a few things before we get to work.
I'll arrange for horses while you do that.
Comments, subscribe for more, and always.